The Boeing C-17 Globemaster III isn't just another military aircraft. It's one of the most successful heavy lifters in aviation history, able to carry nearly 170,000 pounds of cargo, land on rough, short runways, and fly halfway around the world without stopping. For decades, it was the backbone of the U.S. Air Force's airlift capability. So why did Boeing shut down production in 2015? And why, almost 10 years later, is there serious talk of bringing it back? The rise of a heavyweight. Born in the 1980s, entering service in the 1990s, the C-17 was designed to do what no other plane could: deliver tanks, troops, and supplies directly to the front line, even in remote or hostile environments. Through the wars in Iraq and Afghanistan, the Globemaster proved indispensable. It could carry armored vehicles one day, then evacuate wounded soldiers or deliver humanitarian aid the next. The U.S. Air Force ultimately bought 223 aircraft, and international customers lined up as well: the UK, Australia, India, Qatar, Canada, and more. For years, demand was so high, Boeing had to keep the production line running at full speed. The C-17 wasn't just a plane, it was a lifeline. Falling demand and budget cuts ended C-17 production. The C-17 Globemaster III was developed in the 80s by McDonnell Douglas to meet the United States Air Force's need for heavy lift transport that could operate from short, austere runways. The first flight took place in September 1991, and the aircraft entered service in January 1995. Later in 1997, Boeing acquired McDonnell Douglas and continued the production. However, over time, demand for new C-17s began to fall. Additionally, the program also became a target of budget constraints. The 2011 Budget Control Act introduced significant cuts to U.S. defense spending. In its 2010 budget request, the Department of Defense stated, "DoD does not need additional C-17 aircraft. Therefore, we are ending production under this program." With no substantial new demand, the long-term viability of the line came into question. By 2013, the Air Force's entire order had been fulfilled. Apart from a few aircraft for international customers still in production, Boeing began winding down the program that year and completed the main wing spar of the final aircraft in 2014. The last C-17 was delivered in 2015 and marked the end of more than two decades of manufacturing at the Long Beach, California plant. Nations IC, 17 orders amid growing airlift. For years, the C-17 Globemaster III has remained a core asset for the United States Air Force. It is regularly tasked with moving heavy equipment, vehicles, and troops, and is also used for humanitarian and relief missions. In recent years, the C-17 fleet has been used heavily for operations in Afghanistan, Ukraine, and the Indo-Pacific. This higher usage has accelerated wear on the fleet, which has prompted discussions about whether more aircraft are needed before a future replacement becomes available. In addition, defense budgets are increasing in several regions, including Europe, Asia-Pacific, and the Middle East, and more countries are looking to expand their airlift capacity. And conflicts such as Russia's war in Ukraine and unrest in the Middle East have renewed attention on the type. C-17 restart remains uncertain. At present, a C-17 production restart is only in the discussion stage. Boeing has confirmed early talks with at least one potential buyer, and several nations have signaled interest, but no formal commitments have been made. Without a significant number of confirmed orders, moving ahead remains a challenge. Any restart would hinge on resolving the cost and logistics of building the aircraft again, along with the question of where production would take place. A strong business case, likely requiring both foreign sales and possible U.S. Air Force involvement, would be essential to justify the investment. If these conditions are met, the Globemaster III's established track record, broad operator base, and unmatched heavy lift capabilities could give it a second production run. If not, the existing fleet will continue to carry the load for global airlift operations, keeping the type in frontline service well into the future. The C-17 seconds are expected to remain in service until 2070.